And welcome back. We hope you enjoyed all the highlights and action so far tonight.
But before we wrap up, let's get to the final Sewell Andrews Chevy Buick and GMC scoreboard for the night. We got a ton of scores for you. Let's start in the 5A ranks. Permian taking care of Tascosa tonight, 24-13. Meanwhile, Midland takes care of Lubbock Monterey, 62-17.
The other 5A scores, Lee goes to 4-0 on the season, 28-21 over Amarillo. Odessa also beats San Angelo Central.
Abilene High taking care of Plant yesterday, 27-17. Meanwhile, Abilene Cooper having no problems with Lubbock High, 43-0.
That's right, as we scroll through.
There we go.
3A, Monahans over Big Spring, 33-12. And Lovington, the number one 3A team in New Mexico, tops Andrews, 63-39.
Staying in the 3A ranks, Seminole. Actually, that's Snyder taking care of business, 54-28. Meanwhile, Fort Stockton getting their first win, 19-14 over Pecos.
Greenwood over San Angelo Lakeview by one. Close win there for Chet Hanna, 35-34.
Yeah, last second touchdown in 2A tonight. Crane taking care of Cahoma, 36-7. Meanwhile, Stanton taking care of McKinney, 45-7.
Kermit over Marfa, 55-13. And Clint over Alpine by two.
And staying in 2A, Forsand taking care of Plains, 42-27. Good win there for Coach Phillips and the Buffaloes.
And Wink over Anton, we just saw those highlights, 49-7. Iran also beats Wayne County.
And Garden County. City putting up a Benjamin
tonight,
104-56 over O'Donnell. Good win for Coach Vance Jones there.
Borden County also moves to 4-0 like Lee, 45-38. Sands over Sterling City also tonight in Friday Night Football.
Staying in six-man Fort Davis, winning easy 53-8. Meanwhile, Balmoray taking care of Buena Vista. District game there, 60-14.
And Sanderson over El Paso, Jesus.
56-6, and then very best, their favorite team was not their very best tonight. Westbrook takes care of them, 40-22.
And it might be Friday night, but we couldn't forget about the huge game tomorrow night from Lubbock. Number 6 Texas on the road taking on Texas Tech. I will be there live at both 6 and 10.
Looking forward to that. I'm jealous.
All the hoopla surrounding this in-state rivalry. Tech students, Trevor, have been camping out all week long. Jones AT&T is going to be packed tomorrow. Certainly one of the most anticipated games of the year, if not number one on that list. And NewsWest 9 has you completely covered on Tech Time tomorrow, live again from Lubbock.
Of course, I'll just be here at the station while you're having fun. But this is a football show, but the Rockhounds are involved in the Texas League Championship Series, looking to repeat their Texas League title from a year ago. The series was tied at one apiece heading into tonight's Game 3. Winner would move one win away from the title. This was a pitcher's duel between Ryan Edel and Rowdy Hardy. Great
Rowdy
name.
Rowdy Hardy.
And Edel showing his stuff early, although first batter Derek Robinson with a bunt, tagged up by Shane Peterson. Doesn't think he got tagged, some arguing here, but ultimately the manager never wins. Wouldn't be many hits here. Edel first gets Johnny Giovitella in the second. Same story. He gets Clint Robinson in the second. Then he's going to get Nick Van Stratten swinging at some high heat right here. Same story, though, on the other end. Rowdy Hardy gets Archie Gilbert to end the inning after this. The Naturals break through with 2 in the 8th tonight. Win Game 3, 2-1. So not a good night for the Rockhounds, but a great night for football fans.
Well, that's right, Trevor. We hope you've all enjoyed the highlights, scores, and action tonight. Again, Texas Tech. I'll be there tomorrow bringing you all for Texas Tech Live up at Lubbock.
Of course, we want to thank all of our photographers and producers for helping put this show together. Without their help, it wouldn't be possible. So for my partner, Lee Small, I'm Trevor Tankersley saying good night from the NewsWest 9 studios. We will see you next Friday night.